Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to answer the question, what does a music producer really do? Now the music producer's role has shifted over time, and as we evolve in the music industry, we take on new tasks and new faces as a music producer. So today we're going to go over your value as a music producer, what you are and what your role requires and what your role may ask of you as a music producer. So let's draw out, what is a music producer? Let's break down the term. Okay, we have here the first word, which is music. And then we have a second word, which is producer. Okay, so what does a producer do? A producer makes products. Okay, so what is a product? A product is a good of for trade. So goods for trade, which are created via a process. Okay, so there's some type of refinery from the raw goods to the goods for sale. So let's say here's raw goods. What a producer does is take those raw goods and does his process, and then out comes the product. Okay, so that's what a producer does, just as a general producer. So a producer does this system here. So all we're doing is doing that same thing, but in the music industry. So that's why we call it a music producer. We are producers in the music industry. We are people who take raw goods, process them to create an end product. In this case, the raw goods may be a singer. It may be raw talent like a singer. It could be a song. It could be, it could be drum samples. Okay, so it could be drums. It could be anything raw, which is not processed. Then the process could either be adding, you know, melody to that song, to that singer's role, so adding music for the song. It could be rearranging, I'll just put rearrange, and for the drums it could be, you know, manipulating or sound designing, so something of that nature. And then we come up with a product. For example, a product would be a song that's not recorded, for one, which would be just written songs. So not recorded songs, you have completed songs, which are generally what music producers do. They complete songs. That's why they're called music producers, because they see the song all the way to the end and they make sure it's ready for the marketplace, because that product is then going to go into the world where it's sold. And that's where the money comes in. Okay, so we'll put money. That's a terrible dollar sign, but you get it. Okay, so there's a conflict here between not recorded songs and completed songs that a lot of people are up in arms about. And we'll get to that in the next slide. Okay, and that's between the beat maker role and the producer role. So we'll get into that. So not recorded full songs, and then we have completed songs. So I'll put a versus here so we kind of note that for the next slide. And also you have the sound design stuff. So the product may be, special drum samples for a certain record, or your expertise on a certain section. So it's not always drums. It could be your expertise on revising some kind of sounds or picking better sounds. So I'll put drum/sound selection. So as a producer, your job is to ultimately create a product. Okay, so that's your goal. You are creating the product. And that product, again, is either a non-completed song, it's a completed song, or it's revising a song. So we'll call that revision. So in the next slide, we're going to go over the main roles you'll see as a music producer. So the three main roles that you're going to see commonly in today's society of the music producer are the following. The first is going to be an uncompleted song. Okay, now the uncompleted song means the song doesn't have full melody or full vocals, or just fully completed. It's not complete to then go on to be a bestseller. So this is what we would call a beat maker. The person who makes the beat, the background music for the song, but doesn't see the song all the way through. For example, you may send the beat, put a little sub arrow here. You may only have the beat, but then you send it off to an artist, okay, who then adds the top line melody. And then they send it to an engineer who mixes it. And then they send it to another engineer who masters it. Okay. And then it goes on to the record label, whoever, to release it into the world. Okay. So those are the general processes of how the uncompleted songwriter would go about producing. So that's one role of a producer. Most common is called the beat maker. This is the person, again, who makes the background beat for the song. Now, the second role here is the producer who sees a song to completion. So let's put complete song. And the difference here is that the beat, you may create the beat. Now, also, I'll get into, you know, you don't always have to be the guy who creates the beat to be a producer either. But anyway, let's say you create the beat. You then send it to the artist. Okay, and that artist is going to send it back to you to make further revisions. And this is where music production really gets, you know, clever, because you're starting to you're using two different collaborative forces, and you're kind of refining your vision through that force. So you have your initial vision, then you give it to an artist, they add their vision, then they send it back to you, so you add your finishing touches to the product, because again, the song is the product. And then you could still send it off to engineers to be considered a music producer. Engineers have a whole different role when it comes to mixing and mastering. So that's a completely different ball game there. So that's the role, again, of the, and they send it to the record label and they send it out to the world. Now, there's different structures. Some people may not have record labels, etc., but I'm giving you the general overview here. So that those are the two main roles of the producer. Okay, you're going to have one that's a beat maker, one that sees a song to completion, because they make revisions after the artist has recorded. Or they may even guide the artist as they create. So they have full creative control. So let's put it in parentheses over here. The difference between the producer in this case and the beat maker is that they have creative control. Now, both are considered producers in today's terminology. Okay, so complete creative control most of the time. Now, again, the engineers have certain controls as well. So this is kind of like a wild card in this scenario, but for the most part you have complete creative control. Now the third part would be to be the person who focuses on revisions. So for revisions, an artist may send work to you, so it's, you're not starting off a project at all. So the artist sends you work as a producer, and then you make your revisions and send it back to the artist. So in this case, you're producing the vision, you're seeing the vision out. That's why it's called revision. You're seeing it out to complete your vision as a producer. So producers have many roles, many different processes of how you would interact with other people in the industry. So again, the artist would send their work to you, and then you would send their work back to the artist to then send it through their chain of engineers and then the record label and then out to the world. Okay. So your role here as a revision person is to edit sounds, for example, to rearrange parts of the song. It could be to change lyric. It could be to oversee different musicians to add more music to the song. It could be anything that requires revision. So again, these are three roles as a music producer. Now, so the question now becomes, does the producer have to make the music? No, I'm sure you've seen many films where it says executive producer. And it's, you know, he's listed in the credits. Well, the executive producer's role in that case is to fund the project. They are investing in the movie, and they're called executive producers. So if they only sent money to the project, how is it that they're called producers? Because they're producing a product via their investment. So there are many different terms for producer. So in this case, for example, I think on Rick Ross's album Mastermind, P. Diddy was the executive producer, I think. So he either had his hands on the records or he invested his money into the record. Okay, so let's say the executive producer, which is commonly used in film. Now in film, they make this a little more concrete and evident, because producer has a different role in music. So what are the roles of the executive producer? That could be to fund a project so that it gets rolling, so that it can actually become a vision. So that's one thing. The executive producer can also be there to manage talent or manage the raw goods in this case. So we're going to call this raw goods, to get the raw goods together. And then they send those raw goods through the staff, which then processes those raw goods For example, if you wanted to make a video, it would become a video at that point. They would be the videographer, the choreographer, the person who sets up the cars, the person who, you know, gets the girls, the models, the person who does the lighting. All those people do the processes, which then ultimately create the product. Okay, so I was given a movie example in that case, just to give a quick parallel of the two different industries. So if you were talking about music, raw goods would be the executive producer will find the talent. For example, they'll use their relationships as leverage. For example, they may be friends with Beyonce, and Beyonce typically wouldn't get involved with this project. But since the executive producer knows Beyonce and they're very good friends, he or she gets her on the project because they have that relationship. So that's a reason why the executive producer would have certain pull in a project. They would have those relationships. They would have the money. They would have some kind of resource which gathers the raw goods for the ultimate product at the end. So let's say they brought in Beyonce as a raw good, and they have relationships with what's her name? Lana Del Rey, I want to say. I'm probably saying that wrong, so I'll just say Taylor Swift. So they have relationships with Taylor Swift and Beyonce. So the talent manager or the executive producer gets those people involved in the project. Now, quick note, there are many roles in the music industry, but they all have similar roles. So they're different titles, but they all have similar responsibilities. So they can overlap. So the A&R could be also responsible for this as well, or the manager. It doesn't really matter who it is. But for example, I'm just going over the executive producer. So in that case, Beyonce or Taylor Swift would come into the project as raw goods. Then they would use that relationship as Beyonce and Taylor Swift. So let me mark a B and TS for Beyonce and Taylor Swift. They would send that through the staff or the recording staff or whatever was involved in creating the project, whether it's a music video, whether it's a song, whether it's an album, whoever the staff may be. We'll just call them staff here. The staff is going to process their talent, record it, on video, or record the audio, or whatever they do, process the audio. And then ultimately it's going to make a song, it's going to make a video, it's going to make some kind of product that's useful for the ultimate product. Okay, so that could be one song, it could be one music video, it could be a single, it could be a couple songs. Okay, so there's an ultimate product at the end of the day, and that's what the executive producer is, that's what their role is to do, is to bring that vision together as a full product. Again, that product could be not only the album songs, but then you have the single. Then you have the, spelling all this wrong. Then you have the videos. Now, again, the record label might do some of the stuff as well, but for the most part, the executive producer is in charge of at least one of these. So for example, if you're the executive producer on an album, you would take care of everything involved in the album, getting it together to full fruition. If you were in charge of a single, again, same thing. If you were in charge of the music videos, same exact thing. Okay, so that's, you know, what creates a full package as an artist. You're going to have more than just the album, more than just digital stuff. You would have tours, you would have music videos, singles, albums, et cetera, et cetera. So that's where your team comes into play. And it's not all the role of the executive producer, but those are just some of the things the executive producer would get into. So not only would you send money to a project to invest, you can also manage the raw talent of a project, or you can hire musicians. This is very common as music producers, to hire musicians to complete a specific part of a song. So if you can't play piano, you can hire a piano player from the local catalog, or a bass player, and they can lay the bass part for your song. Okay, and you, of course, you give them credit, etc. But even though the executive producer doesn't know how to play piano or bass, their job is to bring ideas into fruition. Bring ideas, let's say, into reality to make it easier to understand. That's the job of the producer. Take the invisible and make it a reality. Okay, so bring ideas into reality. So again, these are just a couple of roles of the executive producer. Of course, there's many minutia about each role, but these are generally what you're going to see from an executive producer. Now, I'm saying executive because that's just a term they like to use in a film, but we're really talking about the producer in this case. Okay, so again, if you're investing in some kind of project, you'd be called a producer. If you are managing the talent and bringing that talent to the project, again, you'd be called a producer. If you hired musicians and had that role and responsibility, on an album or a record, you'd be called a producer. And your job is to bring ideas into reality. Okay, so let's move on to the next slide. Now let's talk about the modern independent producer. So nowadays, the typical producer is going to take on more roles than a producer who is signed to some specific label. So let's call this modern producers. Now, modern producers are in charge of more than just music. As you saw in the slides past, that the producer is responsible for a lot of things, and they have different roles and different responsibilities and different reasons why they're called a producer. So as an independent producer, you're responsible for not only those roles, but more. So you're responsible for understanding music theory and handling the actual composition, or the music production, we'll call it. So forgive the slide here. Music production. So you're responsible for the music theory, the music production. Not only that, but you're responsible for recording, or what it's called is tracking your own artist or yourself. So you have to understand that for yourself. You have to understand how to mix and master for yourself as a music producer. Okay, as an independent modern music producer, you have to understand how to sell and how to market yourself as a music producer. Okay, and you also have to learn how to do visuals or graphic work for yourself as a music producer. So it's a lot to, you know, you have a lot of tasks, and what people do is only do one of these things, which is to create music, when there's 5 tasks that you're responsible for as an independent. So it's, you know, I'm not saying you have to do all this by yourself. You can send this off, allocate the work, or send it to a third party. For example, mixing and mastering, you could send to a third party engineer, which is a person other than yourself, to handle the mixing, which is common. Okay, and you could do the same thing with the marketing, or you could do the same thing with the graphics. But for recording, typically you're going to do that yourself, unless you pay for an artist to go to the studio. I mean, you have to ask who's involved, whose project is it? Is it yours, or is it the artist's project? So, you know, that's a little iffy depending on the situation. But for the most part, people only do 1 out of 5 tasks. Okay, you have 5 tasks as a music producer. So this is for the independent music producer. So just keep that in mind. Okay, so this is for the independent producers. Now, when you're a producer who's in the system, we'll call it a systemized producer, it's a bit different, because let's just say this is, let's put this in order. Let's just say this is number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, steps 1 through 5. Let's just say this is what it takes to complete a song, steps 1 through 5. So for the systemized music producer, all they have to do is step 1, and then they send their work off to people who do steps 2, 3, 4, and 5 for them, because they're in a bigger team. If you don't have a team who can do all that, you are doing 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So you need to learn how to do that efficiently as an independent music producer. So that's the difference between a systemized producer versus an independent producer. You have a lot more tasks as an independent, and you may not be good at every task as an independent, and it's coming out of your own pocket at the end of the day, your vision to come to into fruition. So this is what music production is all about. We went over the traditional aspect of music production and the modern aspects of music production. So this is for our beginner series here at busyworksbeats.com/beginners. So if you're not a part of the beginner series, click that link below to sign up with your email and get started with the beginner series. We're going to go over not only music production, but mixing and different aspects of music production. So click that link below and sign up with your email to get started with our beginner series. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.